Ad hoc analysis with Oracle Smart View for Office lets you work directly in Excel to retrieve and analyze data. You can use ad hoc analysis in Smart View with these cloud EPM platform business processes. Planning modules, enterprise profitability and cost management, financial consolidation and close, free form, and tax reporting. This tutorial uses planning for its examples. You can access ad hoc mode from the Actions panel or by right-clicking an object in the Smart View panel and selecting Ad Hoc Analysis. I'll select Ad Hoc Analysis for the Plan 1 cube and then minimize the Smart View panel to give myself more room. The Ad Hoc ribbon provides quick access to Ad Hoc Analysis tasks. Initially, you see the dimensions arranged in rows and columns in the grid. The POV dimensions also appear as a row in the grid. You can move the POV to a dialog box by clicking the POV button, and you can also dock the POV by dragging it to the ad hoc ribbon. Now let's look at the ways you can modify your initial ad hoc grid. Using member selection, you can select specific members from dimensions. I'll select the members I want, remove the members I don't want, and then click OK. If you know the name of the member you want from the dimension, you can type it in the grid. For example, in this report, I want the gross profit account. After selecting or typing members, refresh the grid to view your changes. Let's use search to select members for the entity dimension. I'll search for and add the total sales region's entity, and then refresh the grid. Selecting members for a POV dimension works a little differently. In the POV, I'll select the ellipsis from the dimension drop-down list and select a member. I'll select members for the other POV dimensions. You can use the up and down arrows to change the order of the members. To view data for other members, just select them from the POV and then click Refresh. You can pivot dimensions to the POV, columns, or rows. The available choices depend on which axis the dimension is located on before you pivot it. If you want to pivot a dimension from the POV toolbar to either the rows or columns, you can drag it to the new location. I'll drag the product dimension to the rows. To pivot a dimension that is currently in the rows or the columns, you can select a dimension member and use the ad hoc ribbon to pivot. When you select pivot, if the dimension was in the column, then your action moves it to the row. If the dimension is in the row, then your action moves it to the column. You can also pivot or change the order of column or row dimensions by right-clicking and dragging the dimension. Note that you cannot pivot the last dimension in a row or column. You can also pivot dimensions based on your reporting requirements. For example, if you are analyzing only 1 year of sales data, you can pivot the year and entity dimensions back to the POV. Now I'll select a member and zoom in to view the next level of detail in a dimension. You can also zoom in to the next level by double-clicking a member. You can also zoom back out to a summary level. The zoom in button controls the level of detail. For example, if I select year total and then zoom into all levels, I'll see all the quarters and months. I'll undo my last action. If I select year total and then zoom in to the bottom level, I'll see just the months. I'll undo that action as well. You can also customize your ad hoc grid by keeping or removing selected members. Let's say that you only want to review total revenue data for the first half of the year. I'll select the time periods for the second half of the year and then click Remove Only. Then I'll select the total revenue member and then click Keep Only. To finish the setup of this report, let's display revenue data for multiple products. I'll use a combination of zoom in, remove only, keep only, and pivot to display the data. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.